Hey guys, Covex here with a look at WarZ that just did a couple patch updates for the 27th and the 28th. I just kind of wanted to show them off before I got into them because they did release the entire map. And on top of that, they added two more female characters to the customization, which they don't look like the best models, but they, I don't know. I hope they're not the final product. That's just what I'm putting out there. Hopefully they change them a little bit more than what they have out right now. So, but on top of that, I just kind of wanted to show that off. They did add clans, so the community tab is actually open. So if you wanted to join a clan, you can do that now. Those are available. They don't cost real money to actually start. They take 20 hours of gameplay to unlock them, and then on top of that, then if you wanted to add more stuff to it, then it takes actual real money to do. And I don't believe they added anything else to the inventory that's actual like game currency. I just know that they did a lot of work to just fix the zombies. I think they actually did update the zombies a little bit more than what they had, and on top of that, just change the overall clan stuff, because as soon as they put the clan stuff in on the 27th, they did a patch for it immediately on the 28th to fix some of the problems that they were having with it. So that's actually really good. But anyways, I'm going to jump into it and probably show off some of the new map stuff. I haven't seen them yet, so this will be a first for me. So I will be back 1 second. Hey guys, okay, I'm back. So let's actually see what they changed. Okay. So, right now I'm at this farm, just went through the rest area and around. Looks like they changed the main road. They didn't add any new other features, like any like other strongholds, but it all looks like a mountain community. Snow. I don't know, it's going to be really interesting. I still wanted to head up to that trailer park to look, but at the same time, I'm pretty sure there's not going to be like anything up there. So it's going to be just really, really iffy to kind of do that right now. It's either show off the new land or go explore for something that I know doesn't exist. So, I think I'm just going to scrap my adventure for going over to the trailer park and see maybe the park retreat. Maybe that'll be something. So, maybe I will go up this way, go past this little town over here, and check it out. Just do kind of a short video, because I don't know, like, playing the game a lot, I don't really see too much of a point in it right now. But that's just kind of my own real feel and opinion with it. I mean, it is an interesting game to try to get into. It's just, I'm just not really in the mood to sit here and try to avoid people and team kill and just do the stuff like that right now. It is cool that they actually put all the clan stuff out, that they put actually worked on the zombies, so maybe I'll, even though I have weapons and shit like that, maybe I'll just go F around with the zombies for a little bit, just to see what they actually changed, because they did say they improved the zombies. And so I'm kind of curious to see what they actually did. But yeah, and I did the mistake of actually looking up WarZ videos and this and that. And if you just type in WarZ, the number one thing that actually pops up for WarZ, there has to be someone over there, there's a bunch of zombies. The number one thing that pops up for WarZ is just the scam and all the stuff that's going on. So, kind of want to avoid, like, that whole aspect of it, because I did watch a lot of those videos, and they just seem really retarded, and I just don't want to deal with it. Like, the last thing I want to do is sit there and have to try to voice my own opinion, which I don't really want to do. I mean, it's a game. Who cares? As long as people play it and they enjoy it, I'm not going to sit there and bash them for it. Like, so, I don't know. The developer stuff, yeah, that's something else, but that is off topic, and I just don't want to kind of deal with that right now. But let's see what they actually did improve with on the zombies. They spawn really far away, so I'm assuming that someone's actually over in this, like, vicinity with me. Because those zombies are really far away. Remember, I have a handgun with one bullet in it. So nothing too crazy. Still have this M16. I think they're supposed to fix chat and stuff like that too. So if you are in a clan, you do have clan separate chat. Which is actually pretty neat. I'm glad they actually put that in there. I see zombies. I don't see anybody down there. I don't see them tripping out and like running around trying to get anything. I do have to eat some food. Which I don't even know if I have. Okay, one bag of chips. So, need to get some food. Need to see what the zombies do. And I want to check out the new area. And this character still is on hardcore, so once I die, I'll make one of the newer model characters, just to see. Okay, let's see where we are. Okay, so I can go around the camp. I don't even know if there's a passage that way to the north. So I think I'm just going to hug this road and go around the long way. It is really nice that they actually did put out a patch, because I didn't think they were going to. It was 20 days since the last actual big like patch update that they did, which fixed a couple bugs. So it's nice to see that they put something out. And they did put the whole map out, but I don't believe that the server's like quantity upgraded, and I still don't see how they're assuming they're going to get 200 plus people on a server. It still seems kind of ridiculous and out of range, especially on such a small map. I just don't see it happening anytime soon. Maybe if they combined, like, two maps of this same size, then, yeah, I can understand 200 plus people. I mean, I could probably see if it was 200 plus people if it was on Chernos. Road over there. Okay, so we should start hitting nothing but the new stuff now. House down there. Actually, it looks like a grocery store. That might actually be the rest area of where I came through the first time heading my way up. Assuming that is either Boulder City. Yeah, okay, Boulder City. Now let's see what is actually over here. It's cool that you can get such a high up view of the city to see how big it really is. It's going to be interesting to see what the snow and stuff looks like and how that's going to actually affect. It kind of just sucked that there's no, like, weathering effect, so your guy can't get cold and, shiver and have a trouble aiming. You pretty much have 100% perfect aiming all the time. I think depending on the range, your bullet might stray a couple feet to the left or right. Still weird that you don't hear footsteps in the game, though. Like, you kind of do, but you don't. So I just don't know if it's just my side. Maybe I need to screw up the audio a little bit or what's going on. But footsteps seem really quiet in this game. Okay, so I guess we're going to just go up to the military base. I'm assuming that everyone who plays the game now, instead of going to the Air Force, like airfield, they're going to go to that military base. They have to have some of the best gear that's on the map at the military base. What is that? Let's go check that out. That looks, like, kind of interesting, unique, just kind of out here in the middle of nowhere. I didn't check how many people were actually on the server, so... Since they're actually doing clan stuff now, I'm assuming there's going to be a ton of clan members, because... Oh, helmets are falling out of the sky. Yeah, I'm assuming there's going to be a ton of clan members. Let's see... Water. At least there's water. Canned pasta. Antibiotics. Water. Can't pick up any of the milk. Okay, let's see. Gas mask, I don't really care for. Military helmet. Don't really care for. Maybe if that was like a big backpack or something. Okay, so that cool little base was, well, cool. Had a couple good supplies. Too bad I didn't have, like, that much food. Had a ton of water, though. Probably end up taking the pasta right now, because I really do need something to eat. I'll get a drink of water. Yes, I did see that there was a ton of hackers on the game now. Which is kind of weird. That goes off that topic of the putting it on the forums and the developers taking it off. The videos that I've seen on that. Which I don't want to get into because those are personal, kind of personal opinions about what's going on with the game. Which is kind of why I'm only doing like videos about big patches that are coming out. Really quiet so far. I probably should run into someone really quick. Kind of interested to still see what they're going to do with vehicles and all the other stuff that they're going to actually add to the game. But for me, I'm still assuming that the game's going to be in beta or alpha or whatever for probably another year. I don't think it'll be released next year. If so, it'll be way later next year. Unless they just, like, give up and go, you know what, we'll just do it right now. I could see a new map coming out within, like, the next 5 to 6 months also. Because a lot of people are going to be burnt out of this map. I think they fixed the random ambiance, too, because I haven't heard anything too strange lately. No Yeti zombie monster roaring in the mountains. Still kind of wondering how they're gonna implement the voice chat too. There's just so much that they can do to the game. That I'm kind of waiting for them to do and anticipating them to do, but I think they just have so many problems of their own just with their own developers and people wanting their refunds and stuff like that that I think is making it harder for them now. But anytime a game people can get on a forum and that many people demand a refund, I think there's something that they need to just step back and be like, look, we're in alpha, we're still just kind of messing around with whatever we're doing. We need to fix whatever problems we are as soon as possible before we start losing people. Because I went from playing this game pretty much once a day or whatever to once a week now or just whenever they put a patch out. military base is up ahead above the hill. Grass is looking really good in this area, like really tall, thick grass. Good place to actually hide if someone runs up. I think the fact that grass is available even on the lowest settings now is really hard for people to just turn everything to low and still be able to spot you right away. Okay, don't believe I'm gonna be able to jump up that way, so let's go this way. Still need to find some food. Kinda bummed I didn't get to finish that mission to go to the RV park, but I really doubt anything was there. Okay, military base should be coming up. Hopefully I have the high ground and I can binox into it and just look around to see if there's anyone running around. Because even if I do run face to face with someone who doesn't have a weapon, they're not going to trust me. The fucking skull, black mask, and fucking assault rifle. I'm pretty sure no one's going to just trust me right off the bat. Military base. I think they said they fixed some of the animations that were going on too, but it doesn't look like it. It doesn't seem like they did. Like, you could still jump straight up from being in the prone position. It doesn't look like they changed how that looks either. Okay. Looks like there's some bunkers there. Kinda wanna get up on this hill. I really do wish that they added more like shrubberies, like bushes and stuff like that to hide in. Cause you've run too far with being in the open, so people can see you pretty easily. And their trees aren't, like, thick denses of trees, either. They're not like a forest. They're just, like, a tree here, a tree there. Okay, let's see if we see anything. I don't even see zombies there. I wonder if they even spawn in this area. Didn't say they put any new models of zombies in either, so I kinda was expecting maybe like military style zombies, but I didn't see that in the patches that they actually put military zombies in. Oh, gunfires. Oh, I see someone. He has an assault rifle, and he has a pretty cool mask on. So, gotta keep an eye on that guy. Okay, he has a handgun also. That guy's pretty decked out. Okay, let's hide over here. I would kinda stay away from him, but I might actually just play WarZ like everyone else does and try to take him out. Stalk him for a little bit. Okay, he's running up the stairs. I can get to a closer location without him seeing me. I don't think he actually ran all the way to the top. Okay, where did he go? Oh, there he is. He's running back down. I do not see where he actually went. There he is. He's still over there. I can get just a little bit closer. Stupid fucking zombies on the way. Okay, he's coming around that corner. Okay, I got him. Okay, so first dick move that I've ever done in this game. I shouldn't have really shot that guy. He did have really good weapons, though. But that's the thing. He had really good weapons. And he was scouting out the top of that tower. And I don't even know how the fuck that guy made it into the building in the first place. So, I'm just gonna probably hang out here for just a little bit. Took a lot of damage from falling. There we go. Don't know if there's anyone else around here. I didn't hear any shooting, but yep, so first person killed. If you were that person. Sorry, I actually killed you. I should have seen if you were actually friendly or not, but I guess that is WarZ, and that's how you should just play the game. Fuck everyone else, shoot before you talk to people. I guess it's time to go see what he actually had. Because he did have a lot of good gear. He had 9 shots. Took him out fairly quick, too, from that far away. Pulled a zombie that either I missed or spawned behind me. All the radios actually work in the game. Zombies still are fucking retarded, so I guess I don't have to worry about that. Hostile over there, spotted him. Just running across the road. Don't know if you guys actually caught that. I don't want this guy to know that I'm here, so. XP, so there's actually XP in the game. Zombies are still utterly, utterly retarded. Guy was on the left of me, so don't know if he was running up that tower or if it was just a zombie being pulled, but there was someone over there. I really just want to run up that tower and get that guy's gear. This is putting me in a really open position. Oh man, this sucks. Should have waited for him to get off the tower so I could just looted his body on the ground. Oh, there's a survivor. Unarmed. We'll have to take him out. Hopefully he doesn't find a weapon. Oops, the guy wasn't up this high. Holy mother load. Okay, Okay, I gotta switch this backpack out very fast. Holy crap. So this guy was... Wow. This guy had to have either been a bandit or just the luckiest motherfucker I've ever seen that picked up weapons. Oh, he has 4 handguns? 3 handguns? Okay, I gotta get out of here quick. He has 2 large backpacks? 3 large backpacks? Holy crap. I don't see that guy down there right now. I'm gonna hide in this corner. I don't think that guy actually saw me. And I don't want to take out an unarmed guy. Holy shit, that guy had so much loot on him though. It wasn't even funny. I do believe I took all the weapons that he had though. Holy fucking shit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Wow. That guy was carrying 12 fucking guns on him. 3 large backpacks. Wow, I wonder if these have more ammo. Holy shit. I've never seen anyone as loaded as that guy was. Okay, so I'm gonna head back to that stronghold. This many weapons is bad to just be holding on to. What's that? Okay, that's a zombie. Hopefully that guy didn't find a gun, because he could take me out anytime he wanted to. Let's put a handgun in that position. Antibiotics where the water should be. There we go. It's going to be interesting to see if that was actually a player kill or bandit kill. I still don't see that guy over here. Okay, I'm gonna have to just book it. Pretty sure I could go up there and get one more large backpack, but we'll let that newbie guy get it. Wow, that was retarded range of hitting me. Okay, please don't run into someone like I did the last video. Okay, just one guy following me right now. Kind of wanted to shoot to scare off the newbie guy, but at the same time, I don't want to give away that someone else is here, just in case I run into someone. I'm really praying that that guy was a bandit, because I still do feel kind of douchey to just kill on him without him seeing me. following me. Shouldn't follow me for too long. Okay, I really need food. I really need to find some place to hide. Kind of just recuperate myself, because, yeah. Well, at least that new guy that was there didn't have any weapons, so hopefully he goes up that tower and finds everything that he wants. He's probably going to be like, holy shit, two large backpacks? It's crazy. Zombies are still retarded. Still don't do anything. Okay, yeah, I have a really long run ahead of me. So I'm gonna probably just hide out here. I don't think I have anything to eat. I have an energy drink. Whatever. So, I really need to find some food, but just kind of want to show off a little bit of what was going on with the patch update. New full world. Killed someone without even warning, but he did have an assault rifle, handgun. Actually, he had like 14 fucking guns on him, so that is okay by me. But, anyways. Oh, I thought I heard someone. Anyways, I will see you guys later, and I will put up more videos depending on how many patches come out. Hopefully I make it to a stronghold, but I will see you guys next time. Bye.